The stage was set today for the Premier's ex-boyfriend to dish the details on his five-year tryst with the most powerful woman in the state. And while Daryl Maguire admitted he confided in and sought guidance from Gladys Berejiklian during their on-again, off-again relationship, there was some evidence too intimate for the public's ears.
Arriving 3 hours early with a strong coffee and snacks, Daryl Maguire knew today was the day he would have to kiss and tell.
Were you in a close personal relationship with Ms. Berejiklian?
Yes.
Yes. Are you still in a close personal relationship with Ms. Berejiklian?
Oh, not after the events of this, I wouldn't be. No.
Admitting he was all but dumped after spending 5 years as the lover of the most powerful woman in New South Wales.
We're always good friends, but it was on again, off again.
The inquiry listened to them talk on the phone.
Can you believe it?
But some of the recordings between the Premier and her partner were considered too intimate.
It trespasses on matters of considerable personal privacy.
The Commissioner pulled the plug and they were heard in private. What we were allowed to hear was at one point the couple was looking to take their relationship public. But to do that, Maguire needed to sort his finances and quit Parliament.
So she was one of those people you can discuss your future with?
Yes.
And not just your future personally, but a potential future for both of you going forward, is that right?
Yes, in a relationship, yes, that's right.
The ICAC ultimately trying to find out how much he told the Premier about his dodgy dealings.
Do you agree that there was at least some communications in advance of the call that I've just identified that raised the Badgerys Creek stuff?
Yes.
Maguire claiming he told Gladys Berejiklian details about a $330 million Badgerys Creek land deal with a Chinese developer. But the Premier said she had no idea it involved members of the famous Waterhouse Racing family.
You stood to potentially get a fee of something like $1.5 million?
Up to, yes. Yes.
A windfall that would clear Maguire's personal debt, he says a debt the Premier knew all about.
I would have raised it to her. I only have a few friends that you can raise these things with.
And while Maguire was on the stand, Gladys Berejiklian was in the bear pit.
The opposition can clutch at any straws they like. The truth is I've done nothing wrong and the people of New South Wales know it.
Cash for visas, cuts from developers, harebrained money-making schemes, all while sitting in Parliament. But for Daryl Maguire, there was one thing that was too far.
I wouldn't let anyone walk around Parliament with a glass of red. That wouldn't happen.
Or a glass of white, I assume.
Any glass, I would frown on that.
That related to a boozy catch-up with a property developer, which ended in an impromptu meeting with the Premier.
Joe wanted to meet the Premier. He said, can we go and see Gladys? Can we go and see Gladys? Something like that. And yes, we'd had a couple of drinks. My recollection is we were there for probably less than 2 minutes. Niceties were spoken, you know.
The member for Wagga trying to earn a cut by helping developers in Campsie and Canterbury.
I'll fix it. You just CC Gladys Berejiklian, all right? You just send it to Roberts and you CC Gladys and send a copy to me. I'll get it for, all right?
Nobody can remember if Maguire did anything with it, but ICAC's not done with him. He'll be back on the stand tomorrow. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.
So, after another day in the ring, where does Gladys Berejiklian stand tonight? Our state politics reporter Liz Daniels joins me from Macquarie Street. Liz, does the Premier still have support?
Yes, Pete, the sentiment among Liberal MPs has not changed. They feel there was no smoking gun in today's evidence, and until there is one, no one will move on her. They're also very conscious of an enormous groundswell of public support for Gladys Berejiklian. But one thing that may get the community talking, it was revealed today Daryl Maguire is accessing a taxpayer-funded defence at ICAC, and the entire time he's been under investigation, he's been receiving a parliamentary pension, Pete, $80,000 a year of taxpayer money.
All right, Liz, thank you.